Hello and welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. Today we have another Cardo PackTalk Bold. However, there's something wrong with this image. Yes, I've taken the screws out, here's a part. But we have this, which should be there. So this has the USB port that has came adrift, and we need to transplant him back onto the main board here. I do have some new ones here on one of the rolls, so we won't be reusing this old port. We will be getting rid of him and putting on a brand new one. Let's get the board out of this, get it under the microscope and see what type of damage has been done. Now we've liberated the board from the shell, we will just take a quick look at this side under the microscope. As we can see here, we have the anchor points, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 traces, and of which I would say 3 of those have been ripped, so we will need to repair them traces first. We can see the pins, 5 pins here, and we can see that the pads 1, 2, and 3 are actually still attached to the pins. First things first, let's get this mounted up on the board and clean up the area so we know exactly what we're dealing with. Here we are, all mounted up, and I've cleaned away some of the schmoo. So let's tin up what is actually usable here and then look at repairing these traces. Okay, so now we've got the site all clean, we have potentially 2 very difficult repairs here, especially this center one here. That little via there goes into the PCB and goes somewhere else on the board internally. I do not know where that goes, but we do have something to solder to, so we can get a wire on that. The same for this one. This one and this one. This one's ground. And this one here, although we have most of the trace removed, we have a nice pad here and we have a big fat via there that if this was to be removed, we could solder it there. So 1 and 2, let's get them done first. We'll add a wire, put some conformal coating over it to protect it and to make sure the wires do not move. we have the three wires that I've soldered on, and this blue stuff is conformal coating and it dries using UV and heat, and that's gone off rock solid, and that will keep these wires in place while we solder a new port on. So what we need to do now is just scrape away the top of the conformal coating on each of these pads so the pins on the port have something to solder to. Now, in order to get this port correctly soldered on, because we have these huge ground planes, 1, 2, 3, and 4, I will be able to get to these side ones, the end ones, with the soldering iron, but these centre ones I won't. So what I will be doing is tinning these up with solder. I will be heating up the area with hot air, and then I will place the port on top. That will mean that everything has flown and is soldered correctly. See there, we've got 4 very nice and uniform anchor points. So that is the bottom of the port. We have some locating lugs, so we've got a locating point here and here, which correspond with these small plastic pins. And that is where it will sit. And as you can see there, all the pins line up brilliantly. I failed to mention that we also have 2 more anchor points here and here. On the original port, which is here, so this is the underneath, there's no metal here and here, which correspond with these pads. But the new ones that I have here, let's see if we can get that in shot, metal here and here, either side of the pins. So what I will do is actually solder up those anchor points along with the pins, because we don't want this port to come adrift again, or at least give it the best chance in life. Don't need a lot, just need enough to flood the pad. And there we go. Now we can start soldering up these pins. And now let's see how we've done. We have what looks to be pins soldered. None of these pins are moving, so they are all locked in. We have anchor point and anchor point at the rear, which the original port didn't have. And then we have the side anchor points here. You can see that's flown really nicely onto that little tab there. And the same for that side. And then we have the ones that are underneath in the center here and here. Again, we can't see them, so which is why we used hot air to heat soak the entire area, which would then melt the solder onto the port. So back up top now, and we'll just want to plug this into the PC and listen for the boopily boops. And we get the boopily boops. So that is now being detected by the PC. and we can stress him out quite a bit. It's a nice new port, it's really strong now. We're getting no disconnections when we move it. I'm being quite rough with that. And it only disconnects when we disconnect it. Excellent. So on to reassembly. Okay, the reason for putting some sealant around this button is because it's for the push down for the roller, and there is actually a rubber gasket here, and it's quite a big one. It usually comes out with the button, with the PCB, but it hasn't. It's stayed in its home there, so I've just put a little bit of sealant around the button, and we'll just make sure there's none actually on the button itself. And it's sealant anyway, and the amount of force for these is quite a lot, so it wouldn't really make much of a difference there. So what we need to do is just get this small antenna wire clipped and installed like so, and we can put the board back in his home. Okay, he's pushed down nicely. What I like to do is put some sealant around this gasket as well without getting any on the gold pins. Just go around the perimeter, just a small smattering, just to make sure that everything stays sealed. And that's enough, and just remove the old sealant off this. Install it, and we get a nice bit of squish on that. And next we just need to run sealant all around the edge. Just before we do that, we'll just give it a good clean with some alcohol. Okay, so that's all been squished in the edge. It looks a bit of a mess at the moment, but don't worry, once the shell goes on, that will create a fantastic seal. What we need to do now is just reconnect the battery. Sorry about that, that was a bit difficult to film there. So the battery terminals are soldered. So let's get these board screws back in. Okay, there we go. So if we just run around the edge now, we can make nice neat work of that sealing. Like so, and we can just clean him up now with some alcohol and paper towel. So we'll just run over him. And as we can see, we've got lights flashing, which is good. So there was charge left in that battery. And we don't have any sealant in there either. Let's give the unit a thorough clean. And we can put the roller back in, making sure to get it keyed correctly. Okay, button's pressing and it's going round. Just want to add a tiny bit of sealant to the cap. And we will put the cap back on. Just plug him in again. And we're charging, and as you can hear, the computer is recognizing it. And that's it, we will leave it on charge. So there is the broken USB. This repair was quite difficult in the sense that not only was the USB port off the PCB, but there was also broken traces, so we've repaired those and we've put on a brand new USB port. These ports have extra anchor points, unlike the original ones, so with a bit of luck, these ports will stand up to a little bit more abuse, wear and tear than the standard ones. If you would like to get in touch to repair your PackTalk, please do. Link is in the description below. Our website is www.ubermicrorepairs.co.uk. We also replace batteries for these units as well. So please get in contact and we'll get you sorted out. Thanks for watching.